All right, let's face it. Rigging a puppet for Character Animator is difficult. There's nothing worse than creating a character that you've spent all this time and effort into making, and then something isn't working. Its head is warping in weird ways, or its arm is falling off, or it has this weird pinch in the middle of its body that you can't figure out how to fix it. And you go to the forums, you go to Twitter, you go to YouTube comments, whatever you can to try to help. So what I'm going to try to do in this video is cover some really common rigging issues that we see over and over again. And hopefully by explaining things kind of slowly and easily, you'll understand how some of these components work. And the next time you see one of these issues, you'll say, oh yeah, that's independence, or yeah, I need to move the origin, or whatever the case may be. Let's start with one of the most common issues, and that's independence. Independence is just something you can do in Character Animator to make a part move on its own. And I've shown this in a lot of different tutorials, but just to show it here, I've got his arms rigged in two different ways. So this arm on his right side is completely independent. As I move it around, it's not affecting any other things in the body. I'm not pulling the head or body. I can move my head independently and nothing really matters with that arm. It's a completely separate element, but it's still attached to the rest of the character. Now that's very different from his left arm over here, where as I pull it, it is warping and bending him all over the place. And it really has an effect on where it's going. So this one, independent. This one, not independent. So let's jump into rig mode and understand what's happening. We signal independence in rig mode by showing the crown icon over here on the left-hand side. So I've got my two arms here. One of them has the crown, one doesn't. So the one that was working correctly, yeah, that's the one with the crown. The one that is not working correctly is the one without one. So if I add this back, that arm is going to start working correctly. And now if I go back to record mode, you can see it's working as I would expect. Another really common thing we see is people making this head or body independent. You don't want to do that. You do want these to kind of work with each other. If I made the body independent, then I'm not going to get any foot pinning or anything like that that I've added to the character, because Character Animator thinks the whole thing should be able to move independently on its own, which is not what I want. I do want it to be attached to the head and to everything else. And then same thing if I made the head independent. Well, then that means the head is moving all by itself, and it's not attached to the body at all, and so you're not going to get any body movement. So it's really easy to just turn on or off the crown icon on different parts to see if it has an effect on your character. So for example, with this character, I made one of the legs independent, and you notice that it's kind of moving off on its own and creating an issue, something that I don't really want. So I can go back to rig mode and just toggle that off, and that's going to solve everything. So the main takeaway is this: if you see a character who is bending in weird ways when you move your head or drag your arms, or things don't feel like they're connecting when they should, it's probably an issue of independence. So try playing around with those crown icons. It's very easy to go independent overboard, so don't do too many crown icons or nothing will be attached to anything else and it'll just be all very floaty. You do want some grounding in your elements. So it's just as important to have non-independent elements as it is to have independent elements. And a healthy balance of those two should make for a great character. Here's another common issue we sometimes see. Characters are mysteriously not bending or moving in certain areas. They seem restricted by your movement. So with this character, in the previous example, I was showing him and his legs and his bottom part were moving along with him. But now his torso, kind of just the upper part of his torso, is moving. And for some reason, something is pinning him down and he's not able to have more mobility. So the issue here is attached styles. So if I select my top character group here, and then I look over on the right-hand side under attach style, I see it's set to weld. That means wherever the origin is for this character, for this group, in this case, it's right in the middle. Suspiciously, that is where the problem area was. Everything under here wasn't moving and everything above was. Well, that's been set to weld. So if you run into this issue, make sure that top level group is selected. And then instead of weld, try selecting free instead. And what you'll see is now as I move around, I have that extra mobility. The whole character feels like he's moving together as one piece instead of just the torso moving on its own. Now, a lot of times weld is okay. So my right eye and left eye, those are both actually set to weld attached styles. And that works okay because I do want the eyes kind of welded to the rest of the character's face. The arms are a great way to show the differences as well. So normally I do have weld set as my attached style. And when you do that with the arms, you are going to get them kind of getting this welded feeling where even if I stretch them really far out, they are really almost like you've just nailed it to the shoulder right there and you're getting that kind of approach. So let's see what changes when I turn his right arm. Let's change that one to hinge. And then his left arm, let's set that one to free. So his right arm here is hinged. And you can think of a hinge attached style as more of like a propeller blade, right? So instead of being welded down that edge, I can just rotate it freely all around that origin handle. And for some characters, you know, particularly with more rounded arms and features, this actually works pretty well. Or if the arm is kind of, the back of it is hidden behind the body, hinge actually will work really nicely and not give you that pinching that the weld attached style sometimes does. And the free attached style, that's going to completely move things off and let them move on their own. So for the arms, you probably don't want free. But the reason we did want our character, our whole character to be free is because we don't want him pinned down on the background. We don't want that, the whole character with a nail through his chest, right? So we do want him to be free. So you have to kind of think about it in those terms. Do I want him welded down? Do I want it to be freely rotating? Or do I want it to be completely free movement? And playing around with those attached styles can lead to some really interesting things. So if you're seeing that pinching happening in weird spots, look where the pinching is happening. Think, are there any origins or areas near that that could be causing this issue? And then check that attached style, and that's probably going to help you move forward. Here's another really common one. So this arm's working okay. Over here, that's looking great. But when I drag this arm, it's almost like it's collapsing in on itself, and it's looking strange and convoluted. There's something weird happening here with this, and I don't know why. I have these rigged the exact same way. Well, probably no, you don't, actually. Let's go into rig mode and figure out what's up. So yeah, quick glance, this character looks okay. But then as I start to dig in, I notice that there's some hidden layers here, like this rectangle that was turned off that's actually part of that arm that was having trouble, or this background layer that you turned off as well. So here's the thing, even layers that are hidden in your Photoshop or Illustrator file are going to be considered part of the mesh of your character animator puppet. So the basic rule here is if you don't want it in your final character, delete it. Either before you bring it into character animator, ideally in the original Photoshop or Illustrator file, or just select it and delete it here. And magically, that made the problem disappear. I can't tell you how many times someone sent something that's working weird and I'm racking my head around, why is this happening? Come to find that there's like some reference photo that they accidentally left in a corner somewhere, or a speck of, you know, some Photoshop, you know, smudge or whatever that they've got down somewhere else. And that's causing different rigging issues. Now, there's a few ways to troubleshoot something like this. There's this little like polygon looking thing with like wires going through it. That's called show mesh. If you turn that on, that's a really handy tool to see what's happening. So if I turn this on, I can quickly see, oh, wait, there's something attached to this arm that shouldn't be here. And that's a really, you know, good indicator that that's going on. Same with the white background that I have around the character. I see this box around him, and I know that that's something I probably don't want either. And then when I'm fixing this for people, what I'll do is I'll kind of go through the different parts of the character and look and make sure the outlines feel right. All these yellow outlines feel correct. And once I run into something that doesn't, like, wait, why does the arm look like something like this is happening? Then I can dig in and find what the culprit is and say, okay, I need to get rid of that. And now that arm should be okay. And we're back to normal. And now if I come back here and look at my character in the mesh, show mesh mode, it's looking a lot better. And I can see all those triangles, how my character is bending, everything's looking okay. This one line, that's the background, and that's okay to have because I do have a background. That's all right. But the parts that are moving with the character, I should know what all of those outlines are, what all those parts are. Now, if you have like multiple hand positions or a hat that appears or something like that, you're going to see a yellow outline around where that area is as well. And so you can use that to make sure all those parts are there too. But that's just a really common thing. Just if you have artwork that you're not using the character, just get rid of it. Number four on our list is checking tags and behaviors. So I notice with this character now, one eye seems to be blinking properly when I close my eyes, and the other is kind of opening and shutting in a strange way. And I could have sworn I've tagged everything correctly, everything looks okay, but there's a little troubleshooting I can do to figure out exactly what's happening here. So in rig mode, I'm going to go ahead and select my top level character up here. So it's got the name and the little behaviors next to it with an 8 or however many behaviors your character has at the root level. And then over here in my behaviors, I can start to understand what each of these behaviors is looking for. So in this case, the blinking is actually not eye gaze, it's actually part of the face behavior. And if I go under face behavior, there's this area called handles down here that I can open up. And under handles, I see certain things have a one next to them and certain things have a zero next to them. What does that mean? Well, if it has a one next to it, it means it's found one instance of that tag and that is what it's looking for. If it has a zero, that means it can't find anything with that tag. And so it's ignoring anything that you might think is happening. So if I actually had eyebrows and I saw zeros over here, that should make me concerned because I probably want those eyebrows to have ones next to them. Now this character doesn't have any eyebrows, so it's not a problem. Now the blinks actually show up in the replacements category down here because it's replacing other artwork when you blink. And here I can see that my right blink has a one next to it, but my left blink has a zero next to it. So I can tell something is up with that left blink. So let's go ahead and look at my left blink layer over here. And I can see that, this actually wasn't tagged blink over here on the side. You can't just, you know, name things however you want and expect them to work. They do have to be tagged the proper way. And the best way to figure out how to tag all these is looking at example characters. Remember, you can switch between the text-based tags and the visual tags at any time. But now, if I go back now to my main character, let's look at that again. Now I see the one is here. So this is a great way to diagnose certain issues. Like if your head isn't moving, well, then twirl up in the face behavior and make sure that your head has a one next to it. Because if you don't, that probably means you haven't tagged something as a head and that's the reason that things aren't moving. Or maybe a certain mouth isn't showing up. Your, you know, ah mouth or something like that isn't working. Well, go ahead and look under lip sync and look and make sure you've got a number one next to all the mouth that you expect to see. This character doesn't have a mouth, so that's not a problem. But in the case where you do, you would want to see ones next to all of those. So anytime I'm troubleshooting a puppet that someone sends me, I go through that list. I look, okay, what's happening here? Is it the eyes that are a problem, mouth that's a problem, whatever? And is there a one or a zero next to it? And that helps me diagnose if Character Animator is seeing what it's actually seeing, or it thinks it wants something, but it's not making that connection because of a missing tag, or the behavior's not set up the right way, or there's something weird in that rigging. So it's a great diagnostic tool to kind of go in there and look for those ones and zeros, and that'll help you figure out exactly what the problem is a little bit easier. Now we'll move on to the last issue, and that is origins. So I notice when I'm moving around my character right now, one arm is becoming detached from my character. It feels like sometimes it feels kind of connected, it feels okay, but then if I move too far to one side, it feels like it's becoming detached. Something is happening here. All right, so let's select that problematic arm and try to figure out what's going on. So I notice immediately that the origin is not where it's supposed to be. So this little dotted line circle that has this green dotted line coming out of it, that is the origin. And because I have it in the middle of the arm, that means when I move my arm around, it thinks that's the center. It thinks that's where it's attaching to things. It thinks that's where it's rotating from. And that's the wrong place to do it. Instead of rotating around the shoulder where I'd want it to be, it's basically trying to rotate around this area and it thinks it's attached to somewhere here in the belly button. What is it attaching to? Well, it's attaching to the next non-independent thing, which in this case is the body and its origin. Notice what happens if I move the body origin up here to like middle of the stomach and then did my arm again. That green line is attaching to that origin as well. So it's really dependent on this other artwork. What I want to do is select this, click and drag it, and attach it up here to the character. And notice how it immediately turns green as soon as I find artwork to attach to. And this is where I can make sure, you know, as we were showing before, this is set to weld or hinge or free. This is where I can set all that stuff up. By the way, if you are not seeing this green stuff show up, make sure that this little show mesh outline and auto handles icon is on, is blue. If it's not, you're not going to see any of this information, and it's not going to be very helpful. You're not going to know when things are attaching or not. So make sure that's set to blue and that's on, and that will make your life a lot easier. And now when I go back to record mode, I should see the origin is moving as I would expect. So anytime you're seeing some weird rotation happening or some weird pulling or things becoming detached, look at where the origin is of that problematic piece. Look where that problematic piece is attached to, whether it's a piece of artwork or a green dotted line, and use that to kind of understand how to move that origin so it's in a better place, so it's going to rotate as you would expect. And finally, just remember that you always have the rigging issues panel that's down here. See this little warning icon that shows up? If I click on that, that's going to scan my puppet and look for any issues that it can find. In this case, it says lip sync. No layers or handles with required tags could be found. Basically, because my character doesn't have a mouth, it's saying that, you know, there's no mouth layers, but I have a lip sync behavior associated with this character, so I really don't need that. That's just more of a, you know, kind of background warning. It's not a big deal. I really don't have to solve it, but if I wanted to, I could select my character. Let's just get rid of this lip sync message. It's going to analyze, and now it's going to say no issues found, and I'm good to go, and I can close this back up. All right, so that's it. I hope that was helpful and not completely self-serving, because I'm going to be linking to the timestamps in this video quite a lot when I'm directing people to help them out. Say, oh, it's number three, or, you know, look at, you know, 4 minutes in, this is the problem you're facing. So hopefully it wasn't completely self-serving and helpful for you as well with some of your own rigging issues. But that's it for today. I just want to say thank you to everyone for supporting this channel, because we just passed 100,000 subscribers. That is bananas. That's crazy. Thank you so much for all the continued support throughout the years. And I really appreciate it. You know, I read every single comment that comes through, because you see me giving little hearts and likes and responding to everything. So thank you for all the support throughout the years. It means so much to me, and hopefully many more years to come making videos and interacting with you all and seeing all the cool stuff that you create. So thanks again for watching, as always. And until next time, have fun.